Hello friends, today we are going to see about Raglan sleep. In the previous classes, we had seen about what is a sleep and what are the types of sleeves. In that we had seen about certain sleeves in detail. Today, in this class, I am going to tell you about a Raglan sleep. Raglan sleep is a type of sleeve which is mainly attached to the bodice. Even though there are various types of sleeves which are attached to the bodice, Raglan sleeve is one among them, which is very important one, which is commonly used. In this type of sleeve, there will be a diagonal seam which runs from the neckline and it extends till the underarm. Is it clear? This joining may be varying depending upon the measurements. Some cases it will be fully till the underarm, some cases in the middle portion of the underarm, like that. Okay. So, these types of sleeves are mainly used on t-shirts, coats, in ladies' tops, hoodies, etc. So, I am going to show you how to prepare a Raglan sleeve dress. Is it clear? So, what is the basic necessity for preparing a Raglan sleeve is bodice. A basic bodice. A basic bodice is usually comprising of three things. Now, what are the three things? Bodice front, bodice back, as well as sleeve. So, for making a Raglan sleeve, you need to have all these things. That is all the three things. That is the bodice, front, back and sleeve. Initially, you have to take a bodice back. This is the bodice back pattern which I have taken. There will be a point, 11. From that point, so in the previous classes also, we had discussed about how to prepare a basic pattern. So, you have to take the same pattern and you have to make some changes in that one in order to get the Raglan sleeve. So, it is very simple. Listen carefully. So, from 11, you have to mark a point that might be up to 1 inch distance on this neckline. Basically, also on this neckline from 11, you will be marking a point which is up to 1 inch away from 11. So, you will be marking a point. See this. I have marked it. So, this is a point. Similarly, in the underarm, you have to mark another point which starts from 9. You have to take a 1 inch and you have to mark another point. So, you have to join these two points using a slanting line. Once finished, you have to mark a center portion with a notch. Notch is nothing but a slash. You have to make a slight slash here. Then, you have to cut the entire portion, that is from 11, newly marked one, then the slanting line, then this portion, then the arm portion, that is the underarm portion. You have to finally come back to the 11. So, you have to remove this portion and you have to remove this portion. This is the bodice portion. This is the portion which you are going to attach with the sleeve. Is it clear? So, you have to repeat the same thing for the front portion too. So, this is the bodice front. You have to take bodice front. In that, similarly, in the neckline, you have to mark up to 1 inch distance. You have to mark a point. In the armhole also, 1 inch distance, you have to mark a point. You have to join these two using a slanting line. See here. These two are joined with a slanting line. Then we have to make two slashes. In the bodice back portion, you will be making only one slash, that is one notch. Here you will be making two notches in order to identify the difference between these two things. Then similarly, you have to cut the entire portion. We have to keep it separately. The portion which is cut from the bodice back is portion 1. This is portion 2. Okay. These two portions need to be attached with the sleeve portion. Is it clear? This is the bodice front portion. So, this is the sleeve, this is the basic sleeve. In the basic sleeve, in the middle portion, you need to make a mark. This is the marking. So, in this off portion, you need to fit it with the portion 1 which is cut from the bodice back. Similarly, in this off portion, you need to fit it with the portion 2 which is cut from the bodice front. Okay. The wider portion should be placed here and the narrow portion should be placed towards the other side, other end. Similarly, you have to repeat this thing. Then you have to trace it. This is the portion which is cut. This is a short sleeve. If it is a long sleeve like this means, this will extend some more. Is it clear? So, this is the portion. This portion is need to be attached with the bodice portion. Already we have seen two bodice portion. No. This portion needs to be fitted with the bodice portion. See here. Like this. So, there will be a seam. Diagonal seam which runs from the neckline and it will be extending till the underarm here. Neckline and it is extending till the underarm. Is it clear? So, this is the way you have to prepare a Raglan sleeve. So, just prepare your own Raglan sleeve and enjoy it. So, we can see the next type of sleeve, that is a kimono sleeve, in the next class. Thank you.